Welcome to the Wormhole, where keeping it real is expected. There are a couple million podcasts you could be tuned into, but you chose to take this journey with us, and for that, we thank you. Without further ado, the Wormhole with Tim and Troy.
But shit, since we ain't got much time, man, let's talk about this shit, man. You said we're talking about these songs, man. I'm very interested in this shit here. I wish I wouldn't have told you. I should have just kept it to myself.
Well, I didn't do you right. I didn't tell you the stipulations and all that.
Yeah. We still get into it.
Yeah, I was sitting around here listening to some music today, and, you know, I get caught in my zones, depending. And, you know, a lot of times, man, it ain't got nothing to do with racism and all that. A lot of the music I listen to is not, well, let me rephrase that. It depends on when the time is. The type of music I listen to, that shit goes all the time. Like, rapping shit, I have to be working out or getting a little fucked up. And that's when rap kind of play in my fucking life. I can't get up in the morning and listen to rap. Like, that shit just be too much for me in the morning. Or if I'm just sitting around and nothing's going on, rap is too much. But the whole thing was, what song or album could you listen to on repeat?
Shit. Let me see. You want me to go?
It's not your favorite song and not your favorite album. But what song or album? And it could be your favorite, whatever, like whatever the case is. I'm not saying that this got to be your be all, end all, like taking the time capsule with you.
Okay, I tell you what. I can switch up what I told you. If it's a song just across the board that I can listen to a few times over and over and over and over and over again, is don't get me wrong, is Heart. These Dreams. It's two white women. Mm-hmm. I can listen to it first thing in the morning. I can listen to that shit before I go to bed. Mm-hmm. I can put it on the motherfucking Heart station. This rock and roll is two chicks. And just the way that they shit, I got their greatest hits. I don't miss not one of them. Even though it ain't but about eight songs on that motherfucker, I know all eight of them.
Yeah.
And that's my ride music.
I'm talking about right there.
Yeah. And my ride music. I listen to 80s rock. You know, me and you get in our zone.
Oh, absolutely.
Check this shit out. Because, I mean, I just look like this. You know, I look like I don't listen to no shit like that. When mm-hmm. I'm out, motherfucker, you listen to shit like that. Like, hell, yeah. Shit jamming like a motherfucker. You know,
80s, 90s rock, all that shit.
All that shit. It. I'm 70s easy listening and 80s rock.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because when it's that time of the year, when rock, yacht rock come on Sirius XM, my radio knob do not change. I'm listening to yacht rock everywhere I go. Only time I might change that shit up is if a motherfucker in a car with me and shit. And, you know, we just chilling and shit. Might be going to get fucked up, going to a bar or some shit. Nigga, I had a couple of drinks. You finna listen to this shit. I don't give a damn how you feel. You should have drove. Because you not finna, and I feel what you're saying. That rap shit, like, you not finna, whatever this new shit is, you not finna NBA Youngboy me all night. I don't want to hear that shit all night. Get me started. Yeah. I dig it. But don't be all that murder music and shit, man. I'm like, man, I don't even listen to that shit when I'm feeling it by myself. I mean, mm-hmm. I'm going to reach back and listen to some shit that I know. That's what I'm talking about, the Young Bleed. My Boss, My Word, that CD.
That CD
rock like a motherfucker. My Boss, My Word's first CD. That motherfucker, that shit be going.
Yeah. Shit,
no matter what the fuck. You niggas chilling. They were talking, man, put something on. I put that Young Bleed on and don't change it. Everybody, but man, you rolling.
You're killing it.
Killing it right now. Don't touch it.
Yeah.
Don't touch even a song that most motherfuckers skip.
Yeah.
They be like, shit, tonight I'm listening to that bitch. I know what it is. I just skip it. I'm with it.
Because it feels so good when you hear it after so that long. Good. Man, it feels so good.
Because you know the song is just not something you listen to daily. But you mm-hmm. know what the song is. It's just like, I used to hate Juvenile 400 Degrees. I did not like that CD at all. I liked a couple songs. But now, shit, you know, me and y'all cast and shit like that. Man, we all kicking that motherfucker play 400 Degrees front to back, nigga. I mean, that bit rocking, nigga. I said,
rocking like a stocking.
Because it just feel good. Yeah. I know the songs. I would skip over certain ones. Y'all like, this? He ain't got but like two songs on that bitch. Shit, let us get to kicking it. I'm rolling that bitch. We gonna play the whole goddamn CD.
Well, see, one thing we all did is we all brought our music styles together and didn't nobody bullshit nobody. Everybody was like, okay, so this nigga like Screw. This mm-hmm. nigga do that. I was mm-hmm. a big podcast nigga. We was like, Troy, mm-hmm. we got this no goddamn Tupac today. We mm-hmm. don't want to feel like that. You know?
Because Pac let the...
He'll suck the ass room. He will suck the ass room, buddy.
He will suck the... Unless you just a Pac head.
Yeah.
Nigga. We done been kicking it back in the day, nigga. And that pop come on, I don't give a damn how many bitches in the room. Nigga, yeah. Stop fucking with the hoe. All the way nigga gonna start fucking with the bitches again. You better play a pop song.
Yeah.
When you talking about fucking with bitches. Yeah. When you talking about tears and closed caskets?
Yeah.
I just want to drink and just talk to my niggas right now. That man, you can get the fuck out of my face. I'm talking about niggas right now. Run it back. Like shit, party really is really gonna turn into just a gangster party. Now the women are left. Nigga, we up here just drinking and we jamming this shit. Now you want to play some Toss It Up? Okay, nigga, we up in here. Nigga, come on, man. God damn it, me against the world? Come on, man. I got to sit down and think about my life.
Yeah, my motherfucking life.
My life. Shit.
You know, you gotta play that heaven and hell at the fine that never call you bitch again. You got to play that kind of shit.
Yeah, well,
rather be your nigga.
Yeah, that kind of shit. But shit, you go down to the shit that we like to hear. No, this ain't no party. It's just niggas sitting around drinking and talking and smoking.
You don't want to play Hit 'Em Up and goddamn shit, White Man's World. You don't want to play that shit. Mm-hmm. Everybody get depressed in that bit.
Get depressed. But you know, just like you said, we back in the day, nigga, you right about that. Because that goddamn lineup we used to have where it was East Coast shit, West Coast shit.
Oh, man, we had it
and
all.
And that shit was just jumbled up. Man, you couldn't miss it. Like, nigga, we jamming Jim Jones, nigga. You know what I'm saying? We bumping all that shit. Goddamn, what them boys' name? That sang that Lucci song. We jamming that shit.
All that
shit. We had everything. Then you gonna jump down, get you some Screw. Come up, get you some Pimp C. Then you get you some man. You gonna get shit. Wu Tang gonna pop on that beat.
All that shit.
You know what I'm saying? Then we gonna fuck around and goddamn, here come E-40.
Here come E-40.
Man. Like nigga, that lineup we had every fucking Friday night. You put that bitch on shuffle.
Ain't missing the beat.
I ain't give a damn who was in the room. I don't give a damn what state you was from. We had something for everything.
Because
everybody listened to different shit.
And we was open, too.
Open with it. Like I say, y'all niggas might call me weird, but y'all going to eventually hear what I listen to. Like, why this nigga in there listening to goddamn Depeche Mode? Because I like it.
Because I like it.
Because I like it. I like Depeche Mode. I like that shit. Like, why the fuck he listening to Kenny Loggins? Because I like it.
Because I fucking like it.
That's it. And you think, goddamn it, I won't pull it out, I will.
But see, my song, man, my song, no matter where I'm at, no matter how many times I heard it, I oftentimes with this song, and quite often other songs, but this one particular, like, I don't ever skip it. It's Billy Joel, Piano Man.
Okay.
Like, that's my shit, nigga. When I tell you the Piano Man catch me every time, because, and I hate it, man. I really hate it because I really want to root for my people. I want to always listen to my people's music and wear my people's products. Like, I want to do that shit, but Piano Man just take you to, he say, there's an old man sitting next to me making love to his tonic and gin. He say, son, can you play me a memory? I'm not really sure how it goes, but it's sad and sweet, and I knew it complete when I wore a younger man's clothes. To hear some shit like that.
It can't get no deeper than that.
I mean, dude, like, that's crazy as fuck. And then you got people like John at the bar. He a goddamn friend of his. And you got Paul, who's a real estate novelist. And David, who's still in the Navy. And a waitress who's studying politics. And a businessman who's slowly getting stoned. Like, these the people in this fucking song. Yeah. And the piano sound like a carnival. And the microphone smells like a beer.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
I know the song. I know the song. I like it myself.
He saying they sit at the bar and they put bread in my jaw and say, man, what are you doing here?
Yeah.
Tim.
Hey.
Every fucking time, man. Every fucking time.
Every fucking time. I got one like that. It's called a Guitar Man. It's by a group called Bread.
The Guitar Man, both of them. The Guitar Man and the Piano Man.
Guitar Man, because I love the poet. He said, but he already know he got to find somewhere else to play.
He got to find somewhere else to play.
You got to leave. You got to go find somewhere else to play. This, you know, you got to keep moving on, man.
Fucking traveler.
Yeah.
You're a guitar man.
You're a guitar man. Yeah, yeah. Now, Guitar Man, the one now that's driving music for me. I got three goddamn CDs full of nothing but shit like that. It ain't not a damn black song on there.
Oh, no. I got multiple playlists. Multiple playlists. Yeah,
it's a play. Like, ain't nothing on there but that kind of shit. And motherfuckers might hear me Nigga, I had that shit bumping. I pull up at the red light. My window down. You think I'm going to turn it down?
Bumping, nigga. I don't think so.
Because, shit, you might need to hear this shit so you won't go over there and do what the fuck you was about to do, which was stupid. Shit, I heard some shit that kind of calmed me down. You're welcome.
Now, don't get me wrong. We are creative. We can push fucking words together. I can't rap for fuck. Like, I cannot understand how them niggas can put them words together like that. I think that's just amazing. I can do it if I sat down a long time and just thought about words to put together, but to just run off, it's amazing. But once again, it takes me back to, why do we take our talents and use it for that? Why does everything we say, even our slow music, even our music that's supposed to make you feel good, is talking about like fucking and the way we approach women? It's not creative. We don't compare women to the elements and to seasons and shit. We go straight for the juggler. Everything's so fucking vulgar and fuck it.
Well, I'm going to tell you why, because that's what's being played and that's what's getting paid.
So that's sexualized.
That's what's getting played and that's what's getting paid. You put some shit out like that, because you come in there talking about NDIRE with that brown skin, one of the best songs.
I love NDIRE music, man.
Man, that song Brown Skin is so fucking lovely.
So
you
awesome.
Don't hear that shit. You don't hear that shit on the, man, when that shit was hot, you might have heard it every now and then, but you don't hear it like you hear shit nowadays. And that song right there was very sexual and uplifting.
But it was creatively sexual. That's the difference.
It was creatively sexual. She never said anything about how wet her pussy was.
No taking my panties down and none of that. No dick sucking and all that.
None of that shit, man. And that shit was fucking, that's a beautiful ass song, man.
We need to bring back NDIRE, do up that thing and goddamn Brown Skin and bring some more Calm and Testify back. Why does our radio stations not sound like that?
It can sell. It can sell if it's pushed, because we had a strong 10 to 15 year. Well, that was really, if it wasn't conscious shit, that's what they were jamming. Because when you get motherfuckers come out talking about nigga, you know, you still have people that rap like that. Because I mean, once upon a time, nigga, if you want to hear some old vulgar shit, it was Too Loud Crew. If you want to hear shit about pussy and all that shit, it had to be Too Loud Crew. And them niggas got banned, right? Yeah. But then as time went on, you start getting other songs and that will slowly start getting it up there. Because Digital Underground had one called, was it Video Freak or Porno Freak? Talking about all these porn stars. And I knew them. At that age, I wasn't supposed to. But I knew them. And I'm like, shit. That is what she sounded like when she sucked dick. And all that shit, I knew. So it got you. But they did all that shit without speaking too much.
But the difference is, and I always have to say, and I have to reiterate, I hate to always bring up back in the day, but in order for you to listen to Too Loud Crew, you had to go look for it. You had to find a Too Loud Crew tape. Like, shit just didn't fall. I mean, don't get me wrong. Now, you can obtain some shit, but it's different now. If it's like Nasty Stuff was where Nasty Stuff was. Even certain shows came on TV at a certain hour of the night. Like, shit kind of had its place back then. And if you was looking for something, you could find it. But you had to take a chance to go fucking find it. Nowadays, you turn your fucking radio on at lunchtime. 100.1 at lunchtime is fucking talk. I'm talking about they even murder some niggas. It's bitches twerking everywhere. I mean, they taking your money. It's the scariest shit in the world.
It's very, very.
If you're not of the culture, it's some scary shit.
Yeah, because I'm going to tell you something. Speaking of that Too Loud Crew, well, my daddy had the album. And you know where he kept that album at? He kept it right beside the Red Foxes. It was in a separate thing.
It was somewhere where you weren't supposed to be.
I wasn't supposed to be. If I want to listen to a record, I had my Gap bands. I had, you know, he had a little couple disco albums and all that shit. And we listened to that. But you go shuffling through that other crate. You got your Richard Pryor, your Red Foxes, all that vulgar shit. The fucking Dolemite. He loved Dolemite.
Yeah.
The Dolemite album and Too Loud Crew was right there. And I'm going to tell you why Too Loud Crew was right there. Because he's the first motherfucker to put beats on the G-string on the front of the album cover.
On the front of the album. It was a few of them, wasn't it?
It was like, yeah, like, yeah. It happened like 4 or 5 of them.
And they was holding hands with their back, yeah.
Yeah.
Holding their ass out.
Yeah. And they were holding, yes, sir. And shit, but see that shit right there, you know, that was so taboo. So he kept that shit in there. It might as well been porn. You know what I'm saying?
But I mean, cool. Back in the days, you know, we always talk about where we disconnected at. You got the hand-me-down albums that your mama or your daddy or whoever it was thought that it was suitable for you to hear at that time. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. When you wanted something to put in your little tape that you didn't got for Christmas, they gave you one of the tapes that they ain't listen to no more that they feel like is good enough for you.
Now, I'm going to tell you, the first tape my mama ever bought me, and I'll never forget it. I think it was on my fucking 13th or 14th birthday. She bought me a little boombox, but, you know, first tape she bought me. It was fucking Tony, Tony, Tony.
Oh, yes. You're not going to believe my first tape, but go ahead with your experience.
Yeah, it was fucking Tony, Tony, Tone, my nigga. And I tell you, I ran that tape to the point where that bitch gave out because I was just so proud to have a fucking tape in that. And that music sounds so good. That's probably why I was such a goddamn sweet ass back then, too. Because I was all about, you know, you just got to be, you know.
Macking the ladies.
No, I ain't macking the ladies shit. He did all the goddamn dough, man. Hell, shit. Nigga, the goddamn shit. I wasn't shit. Hey, man. I was that motherfucker. Motherfucker come to your house and just ran it outside. They wiped their feet, didn't come on in.
I wouldn't work for damn me, Tim.
I wouldn't work for fuck. Bitch can tell me anything, nigga. I'm talking about shit. Such a beautiful lady. And she was like, okay, well, hey, I'm going to call you right back. Brad calling me on the other line. I'm like, okay, whenever you get
I'll
time,
be woke.
I'll be awake. Just call me. Everything is fine. Nigga. I tell you, I think back now, I'm getting so angry at myself. Like, nigga, what was wrong?
Your
with
little
you?
Ass. What was you doing?
What is wrong with you?
And then you should have told her to move around.
Should have said, move the fuck around. Don't you ever talk to me like that. Now tell me, I'm going to get through talking to you because I'm going to go talk to this other nigga. Are you serious? Nah, hell no. Nigga, I'm talking, my motherfucker tell me anything, man. I'm talking about, man. Hey man, I was still giving out Valentine cards way past the point.
I was trying to make sure I had enough money to make sure, you know, shit like that when I was little like that, man.
Yeah, man. I'm talking about nigga Valentine cards, and you always pick out the certain Valentine card you want to give to a certain person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, my heart has eyes for you. And, you know,
that kind of shit.
Like that.
And don't fuck around, get the card with little eyes that moving inside.
That move around. That was the good one. Cause you know what I'm saying, you got a class about 30. Shit. And you know, so mama already pissed off because now I got about two packs because they only come at 24. So shit, what the fuck we gonna do with these other motherfucking things? Shit, yeah. Keep them next year.
Keep them next year.
Yeah. Make sure little broad had the good candy. Oh my God.
But listen, the first tape that I can remember ever getting in my life, like purchased at the store, and I could play on my own as many times as I wanted to. Alvin and the Chipmunks.
No!
Listen, that's not all.
Not Christmas time.
Listen, that's not all.
Not Christmas. Okay.
Michael Jackson, Alvin and Chipmunks. I can't remember what album they did
together?
Alvin and Chipmunks redid a Michael Jackson album. Like, they sung all the Michael Jackson songs.
Oh, my God, Troy.
I cannot remember which album they did, but when
boy,
that is neglect.
That is neglect. That is child neglect.
Tim, when I tell you that was my favorite fucking tape, that was my favorite fucking item in the world.
Well, hey man, and that's why you've been living on Saturn for the past 20 years.
Bruh.
You've been living on Saturn.
Listen, like, I was the only here. Child. I was the only child, bro. I ain't need much to entertain myself, nigga. And when I tell you anybody car I got in, I presented to him when I first got. I ain't care.
Are
if it was an uncle
serious?
Or auntie. I'd be like, can we please play my tape? Like when I was little, you know, some of them would tell me, hell no. Like my uncles, they'd be like, hell no, we not just say that shit. But like my aunties would be like, yeah, put it in, baby. We'd heard that bitch from front to back. We talking about a whole Michael Jackson album, too, about 15, 16 songs.
What the fuck is Chipmunk singing it?
Alvin, Theodore, and fucking Simon singing fucking Michael Jackson. I wish I could remember that goddamn album.
Man, you know what? It's best to just leave it where it's at, dog. Don't do it to yourself.
Boy, man, dog. That was my shit, dog.
You are got to be fucking kidding me, boy.
Nigga, I love that shit, nigga.
Hell, at least I had Tony Tone.
Man,
and my mom knew was straight.
That was my first shit, nigga. Mixing Avenue and Chipmunks with Michael Jackson was like, that was the best fucking Mod Podge ever.
Man, you know what, man? I can't knock you for it. It's weird as fuck, but I can't knock you for it.
Love that kind of shit, bro.
That's the damnest thing I haven't heard in a long time.
I love that kind of shit, bro.
I thought you was gonna say she actually bought you Thriller or
And it wasn't a Thriller album. I can't remember which one it was, but man, it wasn't like black on it, wasn't the one black or white on it, man. I can't remember which album it was. It was one with dun, dun, dun. Dun, 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 dun.
The raindrops falling in the head.
It was that Alvin. Yeah, and when yeah. I tell you, Alvin murdered that song.
Nigga, that was fucking, hold on, I might be wrong. I think, yeah, it's called Why. Why?
Yeah.
It's called Human Nature. Human Nature. Let's see. I think if it ain't bad, it's thrilling.
Yeah, it might be Thriller. I don't know, but I don't remember Thriller. It might be Thriller. I don't know.
It might be Thriller, man.
You know, it was Alvin and Chipmunks. I remember that motherfucking song because that had to be my favorite. And I wore that tape out. Slap the fuck out.
Man, I wore out the Tony Tone. But I would say it is that Tony Tone tape. That motherfucker, man, had a song on there called Slow Wine. And I listen to that shit to this day. That's the only song that stuck out to me on that tape was Slow Wine. Mm-hmm. And motherfuckers who listen to this, you ever listen to Tone, you know what Slow Wine is. And that's the first tape I had. Now, the first time I could buy a tape, I bought The Kings of Bass.
Oh, I remember The Kings of Bass.
It was a straight bass
so
tape.
So many of them, too. It was so many of them.
It was just do, 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 do. And nigga, how about caught the CD? Bought that bitch.
Yeah.
As a grown man. And I had that shit banging, too. That shit sounds so good to me, because I guess if another motherfucker listens to it, they be like, this shit is garbage, because they couldn't rap well for fuck. But they ain't there for the rapping. It's for the fucking beat.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you two things that I don't understand why I like is Kings of Bass CDs. If I listen to that shit now, I would be like, what the fuck was I doing? I can kind of understand it, but that shit was really a lot of bass.
A lot of bass.
That's it. It was all bass. And all bass. Faces of Death. Do you remember Faces of Death?
The videos.
What the fuck? Damn.
Yeah, that shit was
fuck?
Yeah, that's some bad shit. But I'm gonna tell you something. I didn't watch it then, but after I got grown, I didn't watch Faces of Death. But man, like I've seen certain stuff, and I think some people be like, you shouldn't watch stuff like that. It desensitizes you to life. I'm like, no, it don't. It made me watch my fucking back. I watch my fucking back because you see motherfuckers catching bullets. Like it'd be a motherfucker just walking behind you and just boom. I don't think it should be shown to everybody, but I think some people need to understand, like, whatever you're doing, stop, because somebody coming.
That human body, it makes me realize how easy a human body can be laid down. Like, your body ain't shit.
Man, it ain't built for
that. You feel strong. You feel strong as fuck, but it's not built for stuff like that.
It ain't built for that. And I mean, I've had other people ask me, you ever seen Faces of Death? I said, man, if you got a problem with seeing people get killed, don't watch it. They're like, what you mean? Like, they just show like, nah, man, they show it all.
And it's different watching something now that's gruesome as opposed to back then, because it seemed like back then it had to be real. Couldn't nobody fake that shit back then. Now it's so much CGI and shit. If you don't want to believe something, you can just say to yourself, oh, that probably wasn't real.
But really though, Trump, to be honest with you, it still is. Even though they don't release them like that, it still faces the death out there like that.
Oh,
because
absolutely.
It's called CCTV. They be catching all that shit on CCTV. And like, they'll sit there and put that shit out there. And you be like, oh, shit. Like, yeah, it's fucked up. It is very fucked up. Like, man. Yeah. So, yeah, I'm like, dude, a lot of people need to watch that shit. But nowadays, does it even matter? Because you got some of these cats nowadays, they feel like if a motherfucker ain't shooting at them, they ain't living.
Mm-hmm.
Like, man, ain't no way in the hell. I'm like, you know, just to go to the corner store, that might be your last time walking out the house.
Yeah.
And you okay with that?
And the crazy part about fame, these days is that motherfuckers don't mind not being here to see their fame, but they just want to get famous so bad to like, they don't mind getting killed and not even being able to witness it.
They'll die for it.
They don't even care about seeing it themselves.
No, they don't care. And I understand that. Like, dude, you don't care. I understand. Well, I don't understand. I do understand that people like to do drugs and shit like that, but it's certain drugs you just don't need to do. You know what I'm saying? But they still do it because that's just what, you know, if I'm going to be known for anything, I'm known for the pill pop or the heroin, whatever the fuck. And that goes across the board, all colors, you know. And then when it comes to us, as the youngsters, the young black people, fuck it, I get killed, fuck it. You know, I'm ready to die. Why? You ain't even seen nothing. You ain't seen nothing yet. You might not have seen things at your young age that you done seen it from the ages of 18 to 25. But then again, Troy, if they comfortable with that and they good with that, and fuck it. I mean, who am I to tell you?
No, I'm not even saying a person hadn't seen nothing or whatever the case, because you don't know what a person has seen the amount of time on this earth. I'm not saying that you should live because of that. And if you want to leave here, I hate to say this because I went through a horrible tragedy about that, but if a person wants to leave here, it's really nothing you can do about it. No. And if they ready to go, like who is a person to tell them that they shouldn't go if they want to?
And I'm gonna tell you something, Troy. And I know who you're talking about. You know, friend of mine. You know, I've always been of the mindset where people be like, "Well, somebody gonna do that." I'm like, "Dude, you cannot stop them if that's what they want to do."
Yeah, they're not gonna want you to know.
They don't want you to know, so they're going to mask. They're not gonna say anything to you every time you talk to them. Oh yeah. You know what I'm saying? They feeling good, and then boom, the hammer drop, and something happened. Be like, "But I didn't see anything." They weren't going to tell you anyway. But I agree with the point of if you see it, you know what I'm saying, and you see some tendencies, do a wellness check. If that's your partner for real, pull up. Hey, what's up, bro? What you up to, man? Shit, come on, ride with me. You know what I'm saying? Don't give a fuck what's going on. Like, nigga, let's go get a drink. Man, fuck it. For the sake of thing, nigga, let's fuck with some bitches. Fuck it. I want you to see you've been down in the dumps. Nigga, let's make you smile for a minute. Mm-hmm. Let's make you smile. I think if people display that to you, then they're showing you they want help. If they don't display it to you, they don't want help. They just they have a way out and they see it. They don't want nobody fucking with it.
Or I think sometimes people maybe want help, but they hope that somebody can actually see through the fall to get them out of it, because that's kind of what a lot of people want. Once they get to that point, they hope that somebody see them, because their whole thing is, I'm on this fucking earth and nobody sees me any fucking way. That's a lot of people's thing.
But I think when it comes to men of a certain age, you're not gonna try to see through a man.
Yeah, you're right.
You know, you take a man at face value. Whatever a man say, especially if you've known him all your life, you're gonna take him at face value, because he ain't gonna show you any kind of weakness. You know, that's why us, you know, friends, brothers, you know what I'm saying? We will show weakness, or we'll just say, fuck it, nigga, I'm going through. Let me holler at you. You know what I'm saying? Bet. What's up? You know? And, me being the person on the other end of that phone got to listen. And that's the point where you just shut the fuck up and listen. Don't give no points. Don't give no views unless it's asked. Mm-hmm. If it ain't asked, you know, if a motherfucker telling me some strange shit going on with his gal and shit, you know what I'm saying? I want you to be, and they be like, I want you to be real honest with him. Man, fuck that bitch, man. I tell you, the bitch wasn't shit. No, that sometimes they don't need to hear that.
Yeah.
Don't need to hear that. Cause I go off just going off the rip, nigga, feeling good. You know what I'm saying? And then at the same time, he think in his mind, like, man, didn't really want to hit it. I need to hear something to get me out of my funk. You know, I'm in a funk right now, and you telling me this bitch ain't shit, and I knew it, because you're like, because now the motherfucker already beating up on himself. Like, damn. Because I'm quite sure he don't need me to tell him it was some telltale signs X amount of years or days or weeks ago, whatever the fuck. You don't need me telling him that. So, yeah, I had to learn that. Like, man, when your partner's calling to tell you, man, he need to holler at you going through, man, just listen. If you don't want no input, don't say shit. Don't say shit. Now, if you hear him talking crazy, you know, it's always, hey, man, can I say something right quick? And then, you know, but you got to lay it down to him. Like, look here, man, the shit you talking, it's another way to go about it.
Yeah.
You know, I ain't going to be like how me and you be. I'm like, man, shut the fuck up. I ain't going to never fuck
that. Yeah, that's how we. Thing.
Yeah.
Man, that's how we got to get down, though. It's like, nigga, just, you know. Unless you, like I said, if you really sense some real shit, it's always scary when a motherfucker going through something, because you really can't do shit anyway, unless you're going to pull up and physically stop a situation. But other than that, man, it's always some scary shit. You kind of always hope your nigga don't never tell you that he in some real deep funk, because there's really no way to pull him out of it.
No, it's really not. But at least tell me, you know what I'm saying, the way I can be like, so what you feeling like? You know what I'm saying? What you feeling like? And if you be like, man, I just don't see no way out. Now I'm going to be like, oh, nigga, it's several ways out. I mean, if a goddamn roach can survive, you can too.
Oh, you can't compare nothing to roaches then.
Yes, you can.
I mean, I guess black people
can compare roaches. I'm talking about like feelings wise. Yes, you can. You can survive. Feelings wise, you can survive. I'm not saying you can, man. You can survive. It's just the point of, do you want to? I don't understand.
Roaches are the top survivors of all. They are like the
understand.
Survivors.
I'm not saying that you're going to survive everything physically, but mentally, you can be a roach about shit. Don't, man, survive. Get through that shit. If that goddamn roach still see that cheese over there after the house done caught on fire, you think he finna stop?
Everybody
I'm taking this shit to the house.
Everybody ain't got a roach mentality, though, Tim.
Everybody don't. I do agree.
That's why life is what it is. Everybody don't have a mentality.
Everybody don't have it. That's why I say shit. Boy, man, when I tell you, but like I say, when I was back listening to Tone, like shit, I mean, when a motherfucker, girl I was with in high school, that motherfucker left me, nigga, I'm talking about I'm watching BET that night, right after the video and shit went off, and Miss Cleo and Gladys Knight came on, I was about to call her, like, is she coming back? Nigga, I'm in high school, who gives a fuck?
Yeah.
Shit, who gives a fuck, the bitch come back? Now I'm in high school and I'm laying on the couch. Mama said, you ain't even getting to bed. You all right? I'm all right, mama.
Sniffling.
Man, real sucker shit,
you know,
nigga.
You know how many times mine have sniffled?
Nigga, I mean.
Man, niggas all complaining, man. That's what I don't like about this world. I don't mind nothing happening to nobody. I'm tired of niggas fucking being phony.
Shit. How many times you cry, nigga?
Man, multiple, hell. You know, multiple. Like I said, multiple. Man,
shit, that's the only time I really just boo-hoo.
I ain't gonna lie. I sniffed for multiple times.
Yeah, I boo-hoo behind that bro. Like, yeah, I'm about to call the psychic hotline, see if she was coming back. Nigga, I'm in motherfucking 12th grade, nigga. Who cares?
Yeah.
Who cares? And then I'm in 12th grade. You got these motherfuckers and shit in 11th grade. Cause I never really like fucking with younger women.
Motherfucking
11th grade trying to throw that thing beef on lunchtime and everything. And I'm around this motherfucker acting like Simp Simpson. Nigga, fuck that.
Oh.
Nigga, Simp Simpson. Oh, that's what I was. I wasn't homo. I damn sure wasn't part. Shit, goddamn it, I was Simp Simpson.
your own guy, Simp.
I'm Simp Simpson. They like, Simp, shit, down there, Mr. Simpson. Simp Simpson. Shit, he down there at the bar. Shit, crying over another woman again.
Sniffing again,
and got knocked for a bitch again because he ain't man enough. He around here all this goddamn shit, so goddamn sensitive. Hell, yeah, goddamn it, hell. Oh man,
right? Motherfucker walked up to, hey, so Simp, how's it going, Simp?
Simpson. Shit, yeah. Man, a bitch could have bought me for a penny back then, dog.
Oh.
Could have bought me for a penny, like motherfuckers say, nickel for your thoughts. Bitch could have bought me for a penny.
Oh
shit! All she had to do was just say, "I like you," and shit. Here we go, shit. I'm going to McDonald's. Would you like something back?
Oh, yeah, why? Come on, do you want that super size? You going some cheese too,
nigga? I'm going ham.
Tim, I got something for you, Tim.
What you got?
Can you hit it?
No. Just tell me what it was.
Never mind. I was trying to put that human nature chipmunk version on there for you. Listen, Tim.
I don't want no parts of that shit. Cause that shit will fuck around be in my sleep. I ain't got time for that shit, man. I ain't got time to be waking up, make sure my door ain't shaking and shit, man. Fuck all that, man. Listen to that goddamn shit. That shit sounds scary as fuck. Man, cut that shit off, man. Oh, not Troy. Troy, man, you got them folks riding around town, nigga. Hey, them people don't know if they goddamn taste fucked up or what. They don't know what's going on. They think the goddamn tape player eating up the tape. Yeah, you got playing that bullshit.
Oh my God.
Hey man, they should hit the eject button at the stoplight and chunk that bitch out and say that shit gets no play in this ride.
You know how many times they probably wanted to, Tim?
Yeah. They should did like this and told your ass. So you think that's hot? You be like, yeah, that's hot. They should hit the eject button. Let's see how they like it. Honk that bitch.
On the interstate too.
Honk that bitch. Let the wind take it.
Oh boy.
Shit. That shit right there. Man, a human being ain't supposed to be listening to that, man.
You hear it, Tim?
Not recreational.
You hear it?
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
Oh.
Hey man, cut that shit off, man.
All right, I'm gonna cut it off, man.
That shit been terrible, man.
We passed the bridge anyway. Damn, that was awesome.
That shit
took me back.
But I bet it did, because you want to let it play.
That shit took me back.
And you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Damn.
That concludes this episode of The Wormhole. Join us next time to see what shit goes in the hole and comes out the other side gold.